Hi everyone! In this video, we are going to see how to add a text on a surface. In this example, we want to add on this medal an engraving of a text here, which would be straight, so maybe it would be written number one. And here, maybe we want to put a text where it's written congratulations, but the text should follow the curve of the medal. And then finally, we will see how to do the same thing, but on the edge of the object. So first we're going to create a text. So we are going to use text object and we're going to type number one, like here. And to find the little sign between the n and the one, we can go here to put it. And then you can put it in bold if you want. So here we're going to define the height. Let's put 10 centimeter, and let's do an output as a curve like this. So at the moment they are not grouped, so let's group them like this, and then let's see where the size we want it to be. So maybe we can put it a bit higher like this, and we can also center it with the align tool. And then when we are okay with the place where it should be, we can extrude it. So extrude curve, and we can extrude it off 1 millimeter. So type one and point the line towards the bottom, and click, and then you should have extruded your text. So select what you just extruded, group it, and then we're going to do a Boolean operation, a Boolean difference between this object and this object. So select Boolean difference, and then select this, press enter or space, and then select your group and press enter. And then it seems nothing happened, but actually it's because your extrusion is still there, but if you delete the extrusion, you see that you have the number one, which is engraved or has made a relief into your object. So now we want to do the same, but we want to write congratulations here, and we want it to follow a specific curve. So let's say that we want it to go from here to here. We are going to extract the edge of this medal like this, extract edge, duplicate edge, press enter, select your edge and press enter, and then select your the edge that you extracted and type offset. And then here you can define how much you want to offset it. So from the top view, maybe you want to offset it. I think here is fine, but if you're not happy with the offset, you can use the through points and then change the where you offset the curve. Be careful not to snap on anything. So let's say here, for example. And now that we have this curve, we want to cut it with another curve, because the text shouldn't do the entire circle. It should do just a piece of the circle. So we can draw a line here and trim this curve that we just created. So by using the trim tool, like this. And now we are going to create the text by using text object, and we can type congratulation. Maybe everything in capital letter like this. And as a curve, maybe we can group the output like this, and we can put it here. So it might be a bit too big, we can resize it. The important here is that if we want this to follow this curve, we need to first create another curve, which is going to be the base for this to wrap around this this curve. So we need to create a line, but the thing is, this line needs to be the same length as this line. So we're going to take this line and go into analyze and length. So here we see that it's 88.36. So we are going to create a line which is 88.36. Press Alt to have something vertical and click, press Enter. And we want to align this with this. So select the two objects and type Align, press Enter and click on Vertical Align. So that both centers are going to be aligned of those two objects. We're going to bring this closer to here. And then we will use the flow along curve. Also, if your text is bigger, it's not a problem. It's just probably going to go further than this curve. And if it's smaller, it's probably not going to go up until the beginning or the end of the curve is going to be stopped here. So here, let's try to have it at the same length as our curve, like this. And then we are going to use the flow along curve here. So select the object to flow along curve. So we're going to use to select this, then press Enter, and then select the base curve. And it says select near one end. So you need to select your curve, your base curve, which is this one, near to one end, and it will have to be the same end than the other end. So for example, if we want the C to be here, we will select the base curve here, and then when we will select the target curve, we will select the same matching end. So we will click here, and you see that now the congratulation has been deformed to follow this this line like this. So when you're done, you can do the same thing as before. So you can extrude the curve, those curves of 1 millimeter like this, and then do a Boolean operation, Boolean difference. So to do this, go on Boolean difference, select this, and then press Enter and select your extrusions. So actually they are not grouped, so it's better to group them before. It's a bit easier, especially if you have a long text like this, and then you can remove the other one that you have. So you can remove this here, and if you look into Arctic mode or rendered mode, you'll see that it created a relief of your text. All right, so now let's say that we want to put those words on the flat of the metal, on the side of the metal. So we're going to use a similar technique, but instead of using a flow along curve, we're going to use flow along surface. So we will have to create a surface here and then measure it and create the same surface but flat under this those words. So let's use this curve that we extracted earlier and let's cut it with the same curve as earlier. But so instead of using the trim, we're going to use a split. So select this curve, click on split, and then select this one, and here you see that it created this curve. Now we can extrude this curve to go here, and here now we have this curve, this surface. So we want to measure the edge of this the length of this surface. So use the length tool and then select this, press Enter, and you see it's 184 centimeters. So here we want to create a surface that which is 100.84 centimeter, and which is the same height as the height of the metal, and the height of the metal is the height of the metal is 10 centimeters. So let's create a rectangle which is going to be 10 which is going to be 100 by, how much did we say? We say 84, so 100.84. Press enter and then 10, and then type planar surface to create a surface out of this curve. So you can delete the base curve, and you're going to place this under. You can also delete this curve, and we are going to align both together. So, and let's do align vertical center and also horizontal center like this. And and before we actually flow this onto the surface, we want to extrude this, because it's going to be much trickier to extrude this when it will be curved than before. And before when we extruded this part, the actual curve needed to be were all in the same direction to be extruded, while here they will all have a slight different angle, so it's not possible to be able to extrude them as easily as those ones. So let's select this and let's extrude it. Extrude distance. So here we are going to put 10. Now we're going to put 1.1. And the reason we're going to do this is because we want to put those, let's group it actually. We want to put all of those solids, all of those extrusion in the surface, not at exactly at the surface, but in the surface, because sometimes both surfaces are not going to exactly match. So if you do a Boolean division, it might create some problem. While if you bring this of 0.1 millimeter, you're sure that it's going to cross the surface. So is it, let's group all of this here like this. And then now let's do the flow along surface. So flow along surface. So select object to flow. So we don't want this one, we want those ones. So the extrusions. And then press enter and base surface. And it's similar as before. So we want to select the base surface, selecting the corner which is near to the other corner. We want to basically select the same corner here and here. So if I select this corner here, I now need to select the target surface with the same corner, which is going to be this one. And here you see it's not going to work because I selected it the big metal behind. I didn't select this surface. So let's try again. So flow along surface. So let's select this group and then let's select this. And now let's select this here. So select extrusion, not the entire metal. And now you see it created, bended the text, the extrusion, so that it fits this. And now you can do the same thing as before. So you do a Boolean difference like this. So Boolean difference here. And then select this here, press enter. And now if you remove this, and the surface that you use as a base, you will see that it has created the engraving into your metal.